The Peak Tram is one of the most iconic tourist attractions and means of transport in Hong Kong. It is a funicular railway connecting Central and Victoria Peak, a distance of 1.4 kilometers with an elevation change of around 400 meters. The Peak Tram is the oldest funicular railway in Asia and the oldest railway in Hong Kong, having been opened in 1888. It mainly serves people going from Central to Victoria Peak, as it is the fastest and most direct route there. However, there are four intermediate stations along the line as well, which serve the residents of the mid-levels. However, there used to be five stations. The fifth closed due to a lack of passengers, as we'll see later in the video. The idea of a peak tram was first proposed to the Hong Kong government in 1881 by Alexander Findlay Smith, as a much more convenient way to connect the city with the upper-class residences situated on Victoria Peak. Back then, most people walked or took sedan chairs up the steep roads to Victoria Peak. The journey was long and arduous. Construction for the Peak Tram began in 1885 and was completed 3 years later in 1888. The funicular railway was a revolutionary new form of transport for Asia at the time, and the tramway was considered a marvel of engineering upon its completion. At the time, the colony was ruled by racist and often hateful legislation by the British. This led to laws such as the Peak District Reservation Ordinance of 1904, which delineated Victoria Peak as a European-only residential zone. Officially, this was put in place to control a plague outbreak at that time, but many believe that this was just a way to segregate the population from the ruling class. Another product of this was that from the Peak Tram's opening in 1888 until 1926, carriages were divided into three classes. First class was for British colonial officials and residents of Victoria Peak. Second class for British military and Hong Kong police force personnel. And third class for other people and animals. Other features on the Peak Tram included reserved seats for the governor from 1908 till 1949. The first two seats at the front of the tram had attached a bronze plaque reading, "This seat is reserved for His Excellency the Governor." The system has had its rolling stock change multiple times over the years, and is currently undergoing one such change as a part of the Peak Tram upgrade project, which you can find out more about in my video linked in the description. This brings us to the Peak Tram today. The line begins at Garden Road Terminus in Central. The lines here are usually very long, as the Peak Tram is incredibly popular with tourists, which is one of the reasons why the upgrade project is being carried out. Leaving the lower terminus, the tram slowly ascends the mountain. The next station, Kennedy Road, is very close to the terminus. Kennedy Road is one of the four intermediate stations on the Peak Tram, all of which are request stops. This means that the Peak Tram will not stop here unless a passenger wishes to do so. To stop at a request stop, there are buttons located inside the carriages. Similarly, there are buttons at each of the stations as well to request trams to go up or down. A stop request may be rejected by the control room if the next tram is full or if there are long queues. Kennedy Road, like most other stations, has platforms which are longer than the current tram cars. This was necessary before, as tram cars were previously stopped manually, and would therefore require some leeway or error, as they would not have been as accurate as today's automated systems. Kennedy Road is named after Arthur Kennedy, the 7th governor of Hong Kong. Immediately after the station, the tram passes on a steel truss bridge over the aforementioned road. This has become a popular photo destination as the bridge is unique on the line. On the left, after the bridge, comes the now disused Kennedy Road tram shed, which had been used to store and maintain trams. Currently, the siding is being used to store one of the preserved tram cars of the previous green-colored rolling stock from the 1950s. We are now approaching McDonald Road Station, just before which spare rails are stored for the tramway. McDonald Road is named after the former governor Richard Graves McDonald, who had played a part in the development of the Peak. On either side of the station are beautiful stone bridges, which still carry traffic from McDonald Road and Magazine Gap Road over the tramway. These two bridges are as old as the tramway itself. McDonald Road Station is also the only station that retains its original gas lamps. There are two trams operating on the line, which operate in tandem, with one going down while the other goes up. Each tram is made up of two tram carriages, which are articulated in the middle. All seats face uphill for obvious reasons, and even the floor has step-like curves in it to help passengers get off at inclined stations. This is especially useful for the intermediate stations, where the platforms are basically just a set of stairs in some sections. Literally just a few meters uphill from McDonald Road are the remnants of the now disused Bound Road station. I don't know which genius had the bright idea of putting another station so close to the previous one, but somehow the station remained in operation for almost a century, only closing in 1985 due to a lack of passengers. The ruins of the platform and waiting shelter still remain and can be seen just uphill from McDonald Road station. The Peak Tram continues uphill and reaches its steepest section yet at a gradient of 48%. Right in the middle of this steepest section is May Road, which at this point really is just a flight of stairs thanks to the gradient. May Road is named after Francis Henry May, the 15th governor of Hong Kong. Just past the station comes the one and only passing loop on the line, which splits the so far single track line into two tracks and enables the two tram cars that operate on this line to pass each other. The two trams operate on a pulley-like system, as they are both pulled by the same rope, balancing each other on a single cable that is run from the engine room at the upper terminus. The tram cars themselves do not have any sort of onboard propulsion system. The tram then passes through the least developed part of its journey, traveling through forest till it reaches the final intermediate station, Barker Road. Just before pulling into the station, it passes over a small stone-arched viaduct. Barker Road is the only intermediate station on the line to have a station building. The concrete pavilion over it was built in the 1930s. Because of this, the colonial-style architecture of the station also attracts many photographers. When the station was first opened in 1888, it was named Plantation Road, as Barker Road would not be built until 10 years later. Now, Barker Road is named after George Digby Barker, a former military commander and acting administrator of Hong Kong. Now, just a relatively short stretch remains till we reach the upper terminus, the Peak. This station is located within the Peak Tower, which is an observation deck and shopping mall which was built for tourists. The station itself also contains the control room for the tram, and the engine which pulls the haulage cable is located in the basement. Apart from the station itself, the building at 1 Lugard Road was built in 1927 by the Peak Tramways as a workshop, with an additional floor added later to provide a flat for the general manager of the company. The building is still owned and used by the Peak Tramways company, and it is a Grade 3 historic building. Victoria Peak, owing to its history and location, is still one of, if not the most expensive residential areas in Hong Kong. The famous views from the peak also attract millions of tourists annually, and the Peak Tram will continue to be an iconic form of transport in Hong Kong.